Forensic job role number two. So this one is a bloodstain pattern analysis, and there is actually a video to go with this one as well, which I'll show you in a moment. So essentially, a bloodstain pattern analysis would use data, graphs, trigonometry, like what I said in the first video, to analyse where the blood spatters came from due to the angles that they're at, and they can also determine the weapon that was used as well. So it's really putting science and maths together into one role. If you wanted to go to college or university and study to become a bloodstain pattern analyst, you could do forensic science or criminal justice, and then you would do a special course to become such a specific job role. The clip that I'm going to show you is from a Netflix documentary, so all real life, called The Staircase. And it's essentially about a guy that got sent to prison for murdering his wife, but you know, he didn't get found guilty after, I think it was 14 years. It is a really interesting documentary. So if you have got Netflix, it might be worth the watch. I'm gonna show you a little clip now. And this clip is particularly important because it is the bloodstain pattern analysis from that crime scene sharing his findings in court. And you'll actually see that he's not basically doing his job properly, to put it loosely. So just give me a moment, because I'm just going to swap the sharing screens over. And then it should work. There's also another series that I wanted to tell you about afterwards as well, so I'll have to swap the screens back. Okay, this should work now.
Stop it right there.
Now, how did you determine that you were going to strike that source of blood from behind the stairway?
I wanted to see what it would do from that side.
And why is that?
Just simply as an observation.
So you'd rather see it from that side than from the side you thought it happened from?
Yes.
And I noticed that... Can we go back for a second? Okay, let's just replay that again. Let's watch how high you go. I noticed you go about that high, right? That amount of force?
About that much.
Can we play through? Like that. Right? Stop it.
That's correct.
You realize that when somebody's trying to beat somebody to death, they're generally speaking, they're not going like this, right, sir? Generally speaking, somebody's trying to beat somebody to death, they're not going like that, right?
That has nothing to do with these experiments. I was simply producing an impact spatter, something hitting a source of blood, producing a pattern on the wall so that I could go back and pull my strings.
Sir, my question is, was your theory here that Michael Peterson was standing somewhere outside the stairway, leaning in and doing swings like that? Yes or no?
No.
Okay. Let me ask you this. If somebody was hitting a source of blood right there and they brought it back, where would the cast off go?
Again, there's many variables on that also. If the weapon were swung and not a full roundhouse swing, there probably wouldn't be a cast off.
Okay, so I'm going to go back to the presentation a sec. Okay, so just a couple of words in there that you might not know the meaning to. Cast off is the blood that would like come off the weapon, it would be on the ceiling. And when he said pull my strings, that's how they would do it back in the day. So obviously you can see that video is a little bit old, 90s. He'd pull the strings, so he'd put like a pin with the string, and then when he'd pull, he'd be able to see where that weapon was and where the actual object is that was getting kind of hit. So it is a really interesting job role. His evidence in that video, by the way, didn't actually get used in court. It got thrown out because it was that it basically, the theory did not show what the action would have actually been, so it got thrown out of court. Fun fact, there's another TV series about a bloodstain pattern analysis called Dexter, and he is the actual bloodstain pattern analysis, so it's about him. It's not a true story. He does kill people. It might be a 15, so obviously don't be watching that if you're not 15. And the average wage for somebody who does this role is 55,000.